Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming. My name is Rashmi Singh. I work as a senior software engineer at Qualys. I'm a part of the SaaS security team at Qualys. So today, I'm going to talk about how to analyze real-time activity streams for security, and how can we leverage Flink's feature in achieving this goal. So we at Qualys provide a single platform for monitoring security and compliance across all your global IT assets. Our Kafka clusters handle more than 2.5 billion of data every day and have more than 3 trillion of documents indexed in our Elasticsearch cluster. We are continuously collecting the data across the network using various scanner services and ingesting these data into Qualys streaming data pipeline, which is built on the top of Kafka. These data are processed by various microservices, which store their data in their own data stores. We collect all these data and show across a correlated view on one console. This slide will give you the glimpse about the technology that we are using at Qualys and the platform which are supported by us. So today's agenda is, I will start with the problem statement. We'll discuss the possible solutions, which will be mainly focused on the machine learning approach. I will also give an overview of Flink and its feature. Then I will go to final architecture and also have a look on the best practices. Coming to problem statement, the aim is to build a highly scalable system that can analyze the activity streams on cloud in near real time and help us to detect the anomalous behavior and threats. The source of these activities can be the user activities which are performed on various cloud platforms like Google, GitHub, Slack, etc. As we know that SaaS applications are very easy to use, but data can also be exposed easily on them. So take an example. Suppose a document is being shared with a user within or outside an organization, which was not supposed to be happen, which results in a data breach, which is basically a threat. So now we'll look into the possible ways using which we can detect the threat. So the first solution is we can make a predefined rules which gets checked every time whenever any activity is performed on the cloud data. And it lets us know all the activities leading to this rule violation. The second solution is the action manually marked as a thread can be stored in the database, and every upcoming events can then be checked if its attribute is similar to one of the previously marked event as thread. The third solution is training an ML model based on the threats identified in the past and applying those models on the incoming activities to classify them as a threat or no threat. So the scope for this presentation, I will mostly focusing on the third approach. We'll go through each of these steps involved in the machine learning solution, starting with data capturing, pre-processing, training, and applying the machine learning model in next few slides. Before going ahead, I want to mention that Apache Flink is going to play a very crucial role in this approach as a stateful stream processor. So before proceeding to explaining about the precise details involved in implementing the solution, I would like to give a brief introduction about Apache Flink and its feature. So Apache Flink is a distributed stream processing engine that provides data distribution fault tolerance for computations over data streams. Let's look at some of its features. It provides data stream API for stream processing, data set API for batch processing, libraries like Flink ML for machine learning at scale, and Geli for graph analysis. Apart from this, Flink also provides the ability for a stateful stream processing, meaning that a continuous stream of data can be processed by Flink, during which we can also persist the continuous data in our database. The output of processing can be also stored in Flink management state itself. So let's look at some of the real-world use cases where Flink has been used. The first one is event-driven application. So these kind of application are one which reacts to the incoming events in the form of triggering computations, state updates, or external actions. Anomaly detection is one of the examples of event-driven application, where events of a sliding time window is kept in memory, and outliers are detected based on the deviations. Threat detection is another example of event-driven application, which we'll look into the solution architecture. The second use case is data pipeline application. So this kind of system basically transforms and enrich the continuous stream of data and moves it between the multiple storage system. The continuous search indexing in an e-commerce example, in an e-commerce platform, is a common use case of a data pipeline application. The third use case is data analytics application. Flink has been widely used for churning and aggregating a large amount of data to get a meaningful insights from it. So the modern day analytics is shifting from processing a large amount of data in batch to a stream processing. Near real-time analytics also help in deriving the performance metrics of our system, such metrics help us to diagnose the fault in real time and alert accordingly. In a massively distributed architecture like Flink, it's very crucial to manage the states. For high throughput and low latency in this kind of setting, the network communication among the tasks must be minimized. Flink has been designed to provide the rich API for the state management and fault tolerance. For Flink's stateful stream processor, Flink has two types of state based on data partitioning and resizing mode, that is operator state and keyed state. Operator state is scoped to per parallel instance of an operator, which is basically a task, and the key state can be thought as an operator state which has been sharded or partitioned with exactly one partition per key. When we talk about key, we refer to an attribute or a group of attributes of the events which define the dimension at which aggregations are stored and created. Broadcast state is a special pattern of state management provided by Flink. With some data coming from one stream, it broadcasted to all the downstream tasks. Broadcast state helps us to combine and jointly process the two streams. This is ideal for a case when a high throughput event stream can be applied on a set of rules coming from the low throughput event streams. We will see how this plays an important role in our solution architecture. Coming to architecture detail, from a Hawkeye view, the architecture can be described as it all starts with the thread annotation unit, where previously performed activities are annotated as thread, and these activities are then stored in SDFS storage system. A scheduler service, which runs at a particular interval of time, picks up the annotated data from SDFS and feeds it into the machine learning training service. After achieving the trained model, it is persisted into S3, and S3 location gets pushed into the model topic of Kafka, which results consumed by prediction service. Now, all the activities which are collected from the cloud platforms are pushed into the event topic of Kafka. These events are consumed by event pre-processing job, which resides inside the Flink, and it helps in standardization, feature extraction, and entity enrichments on the events and sends it to the prediction service. This is where we have already pre-trained model, which gets applied on the processed event and lets us to predict the event as threat or no threat. And then we can take the corresponding actions. These actions also act as a feedback which can be used further to tune the model. Now we will go in detail for each of these components in next few slides. To begin with, we have a host of webhooks for these cloud storage platforms listening on user activities. These user activities are published to event topic of Kafka. In the multi-tenant architecture like that of ours, it gets very crucial to partition the topic in Kafka. The amounts of data increases in multifolds as more and more data source is getting integrated every day. So the customer ID and the data source ID is often serves as the best way to partition the data. Further, these data are consumed by the Flink data streams, wherein the different adapters are applied for standardization and cleanup of data, and it gets passed into the pre-processing stage within Flink itself. Further, pre-processing job consumes these event and extract the direct and derived events from it. In order to extract the derived events, some kind of metadata is required to be stored in Flink's state itself. Coming to the model training of the architecture, as it must be clear by now that we are using the offline mode for training the model. So the stored annotated data are picked from SDFS by scheduler and feeded into ML training service. The architecture is aimed to support any kind of algorithm and which can be trained on any kind of platform. We run the framework currently on the model trained with TensorFlow, but it is not limited to any kind of platform or library as long as it gives us library to load and run the model. So in this case, the ML service model loads the event as a training set and use the classification algorithm to classify the event as threat or no threat. After obtaining the trained model, we'll persist this into S3, and then the S3 location gets persisted into the model topic of Kafka. Now, when we have a S3 location of a trained model and the event activities from the various cloud platforms, which is published into respective Kafka topic, let's look at how they can be brought together for the threat detection. The model topic is subscribed to the Flink job, which downloads the model file from the S3 location and updates the model in the Flink broadcast state. This broadcast state is copied to the parallel instance of the subtask, which maintains them as a local Flink state. The model stored as a local Flink state is consumed by the threat detection job within Flink itself, which also subscribes to the event topic of Kafka. And hence, at this stage, it helps us in making the prediction whether the event is threat or not. The model in broadcasted state is continuously getting updated by the model topic of Kafka. It is also recommended that we should do a regular checkpointing of a model so that model restoration in the case of failures or restarts is automatically handled. Based on prediction results, corresponding actions can be taken. This architecture derives its motivation from the model serving architecture, which is going to be an upcoming feature in the roadmap of Flink ML. Actions which can be taken on the predicted results are like sending an alert to an admin, reverting back the actions, or blocking the user who performed the action. Before ending this presentation, I would like to mention some of the best practices that I have used. So use Kafka as a message broker. As Kafka topic gets replicated across the cluster, provides the safe data storage. Also, the features like at least once reading and the high throughput. Kafka also lets us partition the data based on key, which maintains the order within the partition, providing the parallel execution. We might be tempted to push the model file in the Kafka topic itself, but it's always better to pass the S3 location and download the model file in the Flink job and broadcast it to the parallel tasks, because the model file can itself be very large. And yeah, take checkpointing seriously. These are the few references. I want to give special thanks to Boris Slobensky for model serving architecture. That's it, guys. Thank you, everyone.